What is a cooling system service, also known as a saltwater service, and why is it so important on a marine engine? Since the early 90s, engine manufacturers have always been trying to improve the horsepower output of an engine without necessarily putting a bigger, heavier engine in the boat. So what this means is the cooling system needs to have an increased capacity to deal with that heat and produce the extra power. This is why you have such complex cooling systems on a modern marine diesel. When someone refers to a saltwater service or a cooling system service, which are essentially the same thing, they're talking about taking off the heat exchangers, after coolers, oil coolers, and fuel coolers, stripping them down, cleaning them, and inspecting them for wear. What can happen is if you don't pull these particular components off, you can suffer corrosion or problems with sealing surfaces, gasket failures, and things like that. And as a result, this can cause internal damage to an engine. The first thing people are gonna say is, why would I touch my diesel if it's running fine and I don't have any problems and it's not overheating? Sure, you can disregard this video if you've got a small horsepower engine that doesn't have an aftercooler, but most modern marine diesel engines will have one fitted. So how often should I be doing this service? The general rule of thumb is that a saltwater service should be completed in between every 2 to 5 years, depending on the manufacturer. Why can't you just flush it with acid or another product called Barnacle Buster? If you look very closely at the Barnacle Buster brochure, you'll notice that the engine diagram of the cooling system they have doesn't include an aftercooler. A cooling system flush is only a temporary fix, and you are really taking some risk by not taking that aftercooler off and inspecting it internally. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure you smash the like and subscribe button, and I'll keep putting out content.